Hello everybody, this is Punk, Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Pikmin playthrough. Last episode, we once again returned to the distant spring to collect one more rocket part, technically an optional rocket part, but I ended up collecting it because this is a 100% playthrough. We now have 22 rocket parts out of 30 collected, and just 3 rocket parts left in the distant spring. However, for this episode, we're going to be returning to the Forest Navelle, and as I've established before, the rest of the playthrough is pretty much going to be jumping between the Forest Navelle and the distant spring. So for this episode, we're returning to the Forest Navelle, so let's go ahead and get started. It is day 16, and we are just about to touch down here in the Forest Navelle, so let's see if we can get off to a fast start here. Alright, so for today, I think I'm going to start off by calling out about 40 red Pikmin. That seems like a rather large number, but I'm basically going to start using my red Pikmin to start things off. I'm going to go ahead and see if I can clear out some enemies in here, because all the fiery blowhogs have respawned, since we've been away from this area for a while. And I want to see if I can take care of most of these guys so they won't be they won't be trouble later on when I'm actually trying to deliver rocket parts. We do have a decent number of these guys on the beach here in the Forest Navelle, so we're gonna have to, be methodical here, and, I think the Red Army of Pikmin that I have, they have certainly demonstrated that they are certainly capable of clearing out enemies of all shapes and sizes, so I have no questions about their abilities to do well, today. And I will not have anybody being distracted by grass, because we don't really need any nectar here, and I'm a bit concerned about the... Yeah, we need to change this fiery blowhog's angle here. We need to get him to turn this way. We need to get these guys to turn away from the water. Again, I'm not worried about the fire attack. The only threat the fire attack poses is that it's going to burn away the flowers of my Pikmin. So that could be a problem. Come on, guys, take him out. You've almost got him. Okay. Now, I established this before. The reason you want to be careful about the fiery blowhogs facing the water is because, when they do that attack where they knock your Pikmin forward, they can send your Pikmin into the water, and we've established this before. Red Pikmin do not handle water very well at all. So we need to see if we can take care of at least this guy. There's at least one more fiery blowhog I want to take care of, and then we'll mostly be done with them. Like, all I'm doing here, I'm just trying to clear things out for when we have to collect some other parts later on. It's always good to do that. Even if you're not going for a particular part on a given day, it is always a good idea to clear out any monsters in the area so that they won't be a hassle later on. So, oh wow, they definitely wanted to take out that last one. Now let's see here. There is one more fiery blowhog, but he's a bit out of the way, and the problem is I don't want to attract the attention of that Wallywog. Still need to be weary of those guys. Problem is that the Wallywogs will be a factor getting a rocket part later on that we're going to have to collect using blue Pikmin. So, we just need to be careful is the thing. Now let's see. We do need our red Pikmin for one more objective, if you will. We need to do some about these Sheerwigs, and I think we just took them all out. Nicely done, guys. Hey, no. All right. I'm gonna set these guys aside for the time being. They're gonna be backup for later on. but I think at this point I'm done as far as clearing a path. Now comes the next phase for what I have planned for today. It's time to return to the landing site, and time to call out a bunch of yellow Pikmin. 50 yellow Pikmin may seem like overkill, and I'm probably going to lose a good portion of these guys attempting what I'm about to attempt, but you do need a decent number of yellow Pikmin for what I am about to do. You guys may remember this gate over here, these couple of gates that I spent the last time we were here breaking down. Hey guys, cut him off! Sadly, I did end up losing a red to that sheer grub. Damn it. Now I'm starting to get these guys all mixed up. Okay, I just want my yellows. You reds will have an opportunity to do something in a moment. So these gates I knocked down earlier. I did not go through this area the last time we were here. I just merely knocked these gates down to set things up. Need to be very careful navigating your yellow Pikmin through here because of the fire geysers. And do not bring them into the center of this area yet. Go by yourself and lure down the monster that lives here. Wait a couple of moments and the monster should appear, and there it is! This is the Beady Longlegs. The Beady Longlegs is another one-of-a-kind monster, much like the Puff Stool. And the way this thing works is that it is recommended that you mostly tackle this thing with yellow Pikmin, because the main weak spot is the rather bulbous structure in the center of its body, which basically functions as its head and its abdomen. And the reason you would want to use yellow Pikmin is because the yellow Pikmin can actually reach it most of the time. There are moments where it will dip its head low enough for you to hit it with any other type of Pikmin, but because yellow Pikmin can be launched higher in the air when you throw them, you can actually, you know, do more damage over time. Now, the reason I'm bringing a lot of Pikmin here, and you can see it kind of working against me here, the stomping attacks that this thing is doing are definitely doing a number on my Pikmin. I've already lost 10, well, not 10, but almost 10. You can lose a good number of Pikmin here if you're not careful. Basically, you just need to keep maneuvering your Pikmin around, and you just need to keep at it. You are probably going to take some losses here, but you just have to keep at it. And our prize is the Guard Satellite. Deep space is filled with dangers. This automated satellite does its part to help guard both me and my spaceship. I'll sleep better at night once this little satellite is back on duty. Alrighty then. So, I didn't lose that many yellows. I lost about 7. I did do a practice run earlier for what I planned to do for this episode, so I guess that helped. And I'm sorry if you just heard my dog bark again. That's the second recording in a row my dog has barked at something, and I apologize if you happen to hear it. I have a beagle and she has a very loud bark. Anyway, now for the reason I brought my reds with me. Let's see. I only need about 20 of you. And instead I bring 34. It'd be nice if you guys weren't so clustered together like that. Okay, I'll just go with these guys. You need red Pikmin to deliver the part so that they can get through the fire. So let's go ahead and see if we can deliver this part. Alright boys, get to work. And there's still some time for possibly a few other things we can take care of here. I'm gonna let the yellows sit here for the time being. Don't really think I have that much left for them to do. Maybe I can do something about this blowhog here. I don't know. I'm not sure if I really want to mess with him. But if we bring up the map, there's a random Pikmin Sprout. I guess it's just a random Pikmin Sprout just sitting over there. This is the area where we fought the Puff Stool, and I do need to kind of point something out here. This is something that was pointed out to me in the comments section, and it's something I forgot to actually explain. I explained that the Puff Stool can release a mist of spores, which will cause your Pikmin to become zombified and they'll become hostile. They will attack Olimar in that state, but Olimar can shake them off to minimize damage, and your normal Pikmin will actually attack the zombie Pikmin. But I think after a while, the zombie effect will wear off, and the zombie Pikmin, which are actually called mushroom Pikmin, they will actually return to a normal state. So that is a note about the Puff Stool that I forgot to mention when we actually battled it. How are we doing on the part? Oh yeah, it looks like they're almost home. So we're gonna get at least one rocket part out of today. That wasn't what I wanted you to carry. This pellet, do you see the pellet? Thank you. You know, this small round red object, that's what I want you to carry. God, you guys are amateurs. Nothing wrong with trying to restock my forces just a little bit. And here comes the rocket part coming home, baby. Right on schedule. Even though I'm not really on that much of a schedule in the first place. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The Guard Satellite, and I just completely skipped over that description. It's just Olimar saying something about how it's protected him from space pirates. And I don't mean the space pirates from Metroid. That would be a hell of a thing. That would be a hell of a thing. Olimar's just going through space, and next thing you know, the space pirates from Metroid Zero Mission or whatever just suddenly attack. And despite what we might see in the Smash Brothers games, I don't think Metroid and Pikmin really cross over, so I wouldn't expect Samus Aran to come in and save Olimar if something were to happen. Okay, let's actually take advantage of some of these yellow Pikmin pellets that we've got here. I do need to be careful though, because, you know, I actually have Pikmin that are vulnerable to the Fiery Blowhog's fire attack, so I definitely need to be on my toes here. And of course, there's that Wallywog in the distance looking at me funny. But it looks like Fiery Blowhog is gonna stay in its area. It seems like these enemies in this game, they do have a certain kind of patrol area which they won't usually deviate from. So let's see if we can get these guys to deliver some of these pellets and whatnot to the landing zone, and maybe we can offset some of our losses. We didn't lose that much Pikmin. I think we lost maybe 9, because I did lose that one red to, one of the sheer grubs. But I think we're going to mostly be okay here. We're going to offset those losses. Let's see, get these guys back in the onion. Okay, you boys get back up into here, and we're definitely starting to wind down a little bit. So let's go ahead and, I did not mean to throw him. I was actually trying to button mash so I could quickly pull all these Pikmin out. And I think we had another successful day, ladies and gentlemen. We were able to collect at least one more rocket part. We managed to take a look at another unique enemy, another boss-type enemy. So, I would say today went relatively well. We won't really be able to build on it for the next couple of episodes because I will be returning to the Distant Spring once again. Like I said, I'm going to be alternating between those two areas now so that things aren't so boring. Because I think that stretch of episodes, we had like 3 episodes in a row where we were visiting the distant spring, and I think that got a little boring after a while. So I'm gonna try to keep the variety up now by switching between the Forest Neyvel and the distant spring, and I'm definitely gonna offset my yellow Pikmin losses for today. I don't think I'm gonna be able to pluck all these guys from the ground, but like I said, we're definitely gonna offset our losses. I would let these guys mature in the ground, but we're running out of time for today, so I'm just gonna go ahead and pluck them out, and I'll just use Nectar the next time I'm playing. So let's go ahead and call these guys back into the onion, and we're not gonna sit through the countdown this time. I'm just gonna go ahead and skip to sunset. And that's gonna do it for day 16, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, so let's get our captain's log for the day. 16 days since impact. When I see the Pikmin engaged in fierce battle with the other creatures of this world, I often grow uneasy, wondering why they never attack me. Could it be they actually view me as a parental figure? A strange, disturbing thought. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so yes, we had 8 Pikmin lost in battle. We definitely offset that by my impromptu harvest at the end of the day, so we were able to actually increase our numbers, so that is a positive result. And we now have 23 rocket parts collected, 7, lucky number 7 remaining, and 14 days remaining, so definitely starting to close in on completion for this game. I know I keep emphasizing it, but again, we are definitely getting closer and closer here. So with 16 days in the record books, 23 rocket parts collected, we have 3 parts left in the Forest Neyvel, and 3 left in the Distant Spring, which adds up to 6 rocket parts, and I may as well go ahead and say it now, the final rocket part is indeed in the final unlockable level, which you cannot access until you collect 29 out of 30 parts, but we're still quite a ways away from achieving that. So 3 rocket parts apiece in the Distant Spring in the Forest Neyvel, and going by the pattern which I've established, next episode we will indeed return to the Distant Spring once again to see what else we can accomplish in that area. But if you want to see that, you're going to have to wait until the next episode, because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Pikmin playthrough. If you folks enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now, and I hope to see you in the next episode.